Hey you guys, this is Glam Zante and I am back today with a new video. Today, as you guys can see, I have pink hair. Now, let me say something about this. This pink hair was really unexpected, but I was getting a little bit bored with just wearing the regular typical black hair, the regular typical white blonde hair, so I had to go back to my crazy colors that you guys know that I'm really known for. So basically I held like a little poll on my Snapchat of what colored hair I should do next. This one was the most voted upon, so I went ahead and did it. So if you guys aren't following me on Snapchat, you definitely need to follow me on Snapchat because that's where it all goes down if it ain't going down on YouTube. So without further ado, if you're interested on how I got this hair, stay tuned. Okay, so when I first got this hair from Ilace Wigs, this hair was completely white blonde, color 613, like straight up. Even the roots were white blonde. I did all this customizing completely by myself. On the box, it tells you exactly what you ordered. So this hair, like I said, was the color 613. It was a hair length 20 inches, silky straight. I ended up getting a cap size in a size medium. And the density of this hair is 110% to 120. This is a full lace wig, and I actually got, I didn't get it with the silk top closure, but this is 100% human hair. It doesn't actually say the origin, but I'm assuming that it's Brazilian, because most of the time when it doesn't say the origin, it's normally Brazilian hair, and I'm gonna check into that, but if it's not correct, you definitely can check the description box, because I'll put that there for a guarantee of what it is. So, and this is the style number FLS019. So, inside of the box when I got the wig, actually was a wig cap, a comb, and two pairs of lashes. So that was really good. I was very pleased with that. And it also had a tassel in it, but I actually have that upstairs, so I'm not gonna run all the way up there and get it. But it was a real nice tassel in it, so I just put that on my door. Yeah, as you can see, the hair does take color, which is really good. Really good, and that's always a question of if the hair actually takes color. And it's taking color, as you see. I was going for a pastel pink look. But before I get into the actual how I did the hair coloring and stuff, I can talk about the wig. So it seems like it's a real good density. It's 110 to 120%, which to me, it does seem like it's 110 to 120%. It's a real good thickness and quality. I actually did like the wig when I tried it on and it was white blonde. It seemed like everything lay correctly. And the fact I liked about it was that with full lace wigs, normally you'll just have lace in the front and lace in the back. But with this wig, it actually had lace all around the complete perimeter of the wig. So yeah, I really did like that because I felt like it was like whole cutouts for your ears and all that stuff. And if you wanted it to be glued, you could. And if you wanted to be sewed, like I had my video up about sewing your full lace wigs down, you can do that as well. This one actually is not sewed on my head. It's just applied as a wig, and I'm using the combs. So it does pretty good. It did come with baby hairs. They were really long, so I ended up cutting them, and then I started thinning them out because they were too thick for me. But the baby hairs were there if you needed or wanted them to be there. The parting on this wig is actually really good. It looks nice and natural. The only thing is, as you guys seen in my sewing a full lace wig down video, this side of my hair actually had all my braids going like this. So I wasn't able to get my scalp to show on this side. So I actually did put a little bit of concealer there just to make it look a little bit more realistic. But the parting on the wig is actually really good. Also with this wig, it seemed like it was thinned out a little bit around the hairline, which I did like because it gave it that more natural look. You know, most with full lace wigs and lace front wigs are really thick around there. So it seems as though this company is manipulating that new hairline of thinning it out a little bit more. One pet peeve I had about the hair, and I wasn't for sure why I was doing it. I just started wearing it like today. So, but I've been dealing with this hair for almost like a week or so. And just with, just for this one day me wearing it after straightening the hair and all that stuff, it seemed as though like when I move around a little bit, it does get a little bunched up back there, and then I have to take my comb and just comb it out. But it's very easy to comb out. It isn't like a tugging or I feel like I'm ripping the hair out when I'm doing it. But it did I don't know if I'm not going to say it's getting matted, but it just would need to be combed out a little bit back there. Not often, but over the couple hours, I've probably been wearing it for about 4 or 5 hours, and it did need to be combed. With this hair, I actually did do pastel pink, as I said. And I wanted to do a more deeper pink at the end, so I ended up going ahead and using Manic Panic Cotton Candy Pink, I believe. Yeah, and I used Manic Panic Hot Pink at the ends of this. I went ahead and just colored the hair and went ahead and let it air dry. And then after it air dried, I tried it on my head to see if I still wanted to do black roots. Initially, I wanted to do black roots with it, but I wasn't for sure. But after trying to wig on, I was like, what the heck? Go ahead and do the black roots. So I actually went to my local beauty supply store and actually got Adore Me Color Off Black. And just went in part by part and did black roots all over the whole entire wig. This wig, I would give it a thumbs up, and from a 1 to a 10, I'm probably going to give this wig maybe a 7 or an 8. I like the wig a lot, but I don't like that little, you know, I have to comb it out thing. And then another thing about it is with the parting, like I said, it looks natural. It does have really good parting on it, but I have to see what it looks like on the other side, and I didn't try that, so I need to know if the parting would look natural far as the beginning hairline right here with my scalp mixed in with it, and I wasn't able to do that, as I told you guys. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. I hope you like this hair. I wanted to do a different look and try something new. So yeah. So let me know what you guys are thinking, and just comment, like, and subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Mwah. See ya.